Hello everyone. The Groups tool is a wonderful collaborative learning option that allows instructors to organize their class into smaller teams to complete graded work and ungraded activities. In this video, you will learn how to create and manage groups. Let's take a look. Make sure you're logged into your Blackboard account and navigate to a course of your choice. Click the Groups tab on the course menu at the top of the page. The Group Sets page shows all the group sets and their corresponding groups. Groups provide students a dedicated space to collaborate, share materials, and communicate with their teammates. You can create group sets for graded work, including assignments, tests, and discussions. Also, you can create as many course groups as you want with any number of students in each group. Now, let's create a new group set for a graded assignment with two groups. On the Groups page, select the New Group Set button at the top right side of the page. Type a meaningful group set title at the top of the page. Next, select the Group Students menu and choose how you want to divide your students into groups: custom, randomly assigned, or self-enrollment. If you choose randomly assigned, Blackboard automatically assigns the students to the specific number of groups. The self-enrollment option creates a sign-up sheet so the students can pick their own groups. You can also reuse existing groups if desired. Choose the custom option to manually assign students to specific groups. Now select the Create Plus button below the list of students to add a new group. Enter a group name and optional group description that will appear to the group members. Repeat these steps to create additional groups. Now let's add the students to their groups. Select the menu next to a student's name in the unassigned students area and choose a group from the list. The students' names appear in the groups below. Repeat these steps to assign the remaining students to a group. Also, you can select multiple students at one time and assign them to a group. Finally, choose the desired option from the visibility menu at the top of the page. Students won't see a group assignment in your course until you make it visible. Choose the Save button at the bottom when you're done. New group sets appear at the top of the page. On this page, you can see all of the group sets in the course, the number of groups in each set, and how many members there are. The group sets cannot be reordered, but you can sort the group sets by name or number of members in ascending or descending order. If you select the arrow beside a group set's name, the set expands to display the groups available and a message option for each group. Next to the arrow, you can choose the More Options menu to send a message, edit, delete, or export a group set. Finally, you can select the Import Group Set button at the top of the page to import groups from another course or LMS. Now let's open a group set and look at the management options available. On the Groups page, you can see all the groups in the set. You can add additional groups and change the student memberships if desired. The group name and group descriptions can easily be edited directly on the page using the edit buttons available. If you select the Group Options menu on the right side, you can send a group message, unassign members, delete the group, or enter the group's workspace. If you make any changes, be sure to press the Save button at the bottom right of the page. Finally, at the top of the page, you can adjust the visibility options and import groups, export groups, message all groups, and unassign all group members. To create a group assignment, discussion, or test, Go to the item settings, scroll down, and select the Assign to Groups option at the bottom of the panel. And select the correct group set from the group students list. Make sure you click Save at the bottom right to confirm the change. If you have any more questions or need further assistance, feel free to reach out to the e-learning support team.